It is a crucial moment for one of the most closely watched bills working its way through the U.S. Congress. The For the People Act is Democrats' voting rights and campaign reform measure. Already passed by the House, today it met a critical and high-powered Senate committee test. Lisa Desjardins reports.
Usually uneventful.
I call this meeting to order.
Today, the Senate Rules Committee was the hub of the highest stakes political fight over voting itself and whether to expand voting access in all 50 states with more early voting, absentees, and mail voting, or to restrict those ideas out of concern for fraud. Democrats are pushing a bill, the For the People Act, to rewrite many aspects of elections. This as 11 states have passed new laws of varying degrees that tighten ballot scrutiny and decrease voting access, some shortening timelines for early or absentee voting, some stepping up voter ID requirements. A 12th state, Texas, is debating a new voting law this week. Democrats see oppression.
These bills that are moving in state capitals across America are not empty threats. They are real efforts to stop people from voting.
Don't tell us these laws are about voter fraud. You're more likely in America to be struck by lightning than commit voter fraud.
Rare testimony from Democratic Senate Leader Chuck Schumer, followed by equally rare committee rebuttal by Republican Senate Leader Mitch McConnell.
This legislation will let Washington Democrats dictate the terms of their own reelection races by rewriting all 50 states' election laws. Let's call it what it is. Put aside the flowery language. This is a partisan effort to take over how you do, how you conduct elections in our country.
A clear picture that both parties see this as a fight over power and who determines it. House Democrats passed the For the People Act and sent it to the Senate in March. It requires 2 weeks of early voting in all states. It also tackles campaign law, requiring far more donor disclosure and opens up public financing of campaigns. Republicans particularly dislike that it allows for absentee ballot collection, which they call harvesting, in all states. But that was not the only sharp topic.
I believe it is the intent of this bill to register to vote millions of illegal aliens for the purpose of diluting the vote of American citizens.
Senator Ted Cruz raised a claim echoed in conservative media that the bill itself is an attempt at voter fraud. Democrats pushed back forcefully, but simply, by asking for evidence.
Do you have any studies you want to present for the record that document extensive mistakes being made?
I'd like to again offer you the opportunity in good faith, Senator Cruz, to present any evidence for the record to this committee that in any of the states where this policy exists, there's any widespread registration or voting by people who should not be eligible to vote.
But there was also real civil engagement, like over the Federal Elections Commission, split evenly between the parties. Now, Democrats say it is paralyzed.
Right now, we have a dysfunctional Federal Election Commission. Everyone knows that.
You're assuming that because frequently the FEC differs, that somehow it's dysfunctional.
Or even over the big topic here, the reality or not of voter fraud.
In my state, in 2014, we had three people convicted of vote buying and fraudulent use of absentee ballots. Since 2010, 16 convicted of vote buying. I just want to make the point that when we're talking about fraud, it is not the fact that this is a non-existent problem.
To respond to that, we know how exceedingly rare this fraud is, and I do not think that that excuse of fraud should be used to make it hard for everyone else to vote.
And Lisa joins me now. So, Lisa, this hearing has been going on since this morning, going on all day. Tell us where this measure stands in the committee and in the Senate overall.
Our team has been watching this closely, and I've been talking to my sources in and out of the committee room. Here's the situation with this very important debate happening. With this bill, Judy, Democrats have two problems. One is Republicans. So far, there's not a single Republican expressing even any warmth to what they see in this bill so far. The other problem is a single Democrat. 49 Senate Democrats have signed on to this bill. The one who has not, Joe Manchin of West Virginia, a name we talk about a lot here on this show. Now, Manchin has not said he's against the bill, Democrats do need him to sign on, though, in order for this to move forward. Because here's what's going on. Usually in the committee process, committees can move bills that the majority favors Democrats. But here's a strange situation. Senate Rules Committee has 9 members who are Republican and 9 who are Democrats. We expect within minutes, when the final vote is taken today by this committee, that this vote will be a tie, 9-9, and therefore the bill technically won't be able to move forward. Democrats will have to move around that and move it to the floor using special rules that they issued during this 50-50 Senate. But to do that, they need every Democratic senator to get on board. So we're seeing negotiations behind the scenes with Joe Manchin, who has some concerns about what this means for states. And in fact, Democrats now in the Senate are changing this bill to give states more flexibility. Rural states have different needs than states with fewer, you know, rural areas. So I think we're going to see this bill change a little bit. A lot of negotiations with Manchin and others. Democrats still would like to get some Republicans on board. Republicans like some aspects of this bill, but not many. And Chuck Schumer, the Democratic leader, Judy, has said he will have a vote on this bill this year. So even if he doesn't have the votes, we will see where everyone on the Senate stands on this important issue. We don't know when yet. We know he'd like to do it before September. We'll see.
No question about it. Important bill. So many people watching this, Lisa, it has enormous consequences. And if there are changes in the Senate, of course, then it has to go back to the House. So still a lot to be determined. Lisa Desjardins watching it all day long for us and into the night. Thank you, Lisa.